My character is the DJ in the local youth club, who basically plays chart music, and that's all well and good, and it's all great for the youth club. But then the influx of Northern Soul starts to rear its head in the club, and my the Partridge Family and David Cassidy aren't really what people want anymore. So I am ousted, and they want to play their stuff, and it's a very slow kind of movement. It's an uprising, but as part of that uprising, I'm usurped and kind of told where to go. So I've had my chips as a DJ at the youth club, and then it moves to the big clubs, really. So I would imagine once they've realised that there's bigger and better venues for Northern Soul, that my poor old youth club job is well and truly over. Do you know, it's a mystery to me, really, how it happened. Kind of mainly white, working class Northerners listening to extremely rare Motown and soul of unsigned artists. It's an absolute phenomenon. I mean, it's within its period. Don't get me wrong, it's repeated later with the rave scene and a totally different kind of music. So with every kind of subculture that's created by music, that particular one was Northern Soul. Later on, it was the rave scene. But it was so niche, though. I mean, the rave scene was national, but this was kind of confined to the North. And as I've said before, it strikes me so odd that Mancunian DJs would fly out to Detroit and go through the records and listen to them in listening booths just to go. But they had such finely tuned ears to know what the public want. You know, that's one thing I've always loved about a DJ of that calibre, is to know what the crowd wants there and then. Do you know what I mean? It's a gift, really. The thing about, I've done DJing, and the thing about the mechanics is one thing. It's all about your taste, really. You've got to share your taste with the crowd, do you know what I mean? You don't want to sit down and protest. Knew Elaine before. I'd done a photo shoot with Elaine. I got on famously with her. She's so lovely, just normal, down to earth, you know. And I heard she was doing it, and I literally said to her, "Oh, is there anything for me?" She went, "Will you be in it?" I went, "Yeah, of course I will. I wouldn't hesitate." I said, "Yeah, absolutely." So she went, "Yeah, okay." And here I am. That's how it worked. I just said, "Yeah, I'd love to be," because I've got a lot of respect for her. But she's got two things: an absolute passion for the subject, and at the same time, an absolute vision as a photographer. So she's got, you know, that's got to be a good director. And let's hope, because I haven't seen it yet, so let's hope that's true tonight.